Hi, my name is Morgan Mosley, and I'm a PhD student in the Neuroscience Institute at Georgia State University. I work in Dr. Nancy Forger's lab, where we study the development of sex differences in the brain. I'd like to tell you about our paper looking at the effects of inhibiting DNA methylation early in life on the development of sex differences in neuronal cell phenotype. There are many sex differences in the brain, and some of the best studied examples are differences in neuron number. In rodents, many of these sex differences are due to gonadal hormone-dependent cell death. However, even if you prevent this developmental cell death, some sex differences remain. These tend to be differences in our neuronal phenotype. For example, male mice have more neurons making calbendin than do females in the medial preoptic area of the hypothalamus, and this difference remains even in Bax knockout mice, in which virtually all neuronal cell death is prevented. If cell death doesn't underlie these sex differences, what does? We hypothesize that these may reflect cell fate decisions that depend on epigenetic mechanisms such as DNA methylation. DNA can be modified by the addition of a methyl group to cytosine residues. This is usually associated with gene repression and is controlled by enzymes called DNA methyltransferases, or DNMTs. To test whether DNA methylation underlies sex differences in neuronal phenotype, we injected zebularin, a DNMT inhibitor, or saline, into the cerebral ventricles of mice on the day of birth and one day later. We then examined the pups' brains at weaning. We found that neonatal inhibition of DNA methylation caused long-term changes in the number of cells expressing specific markers, and in some cases eliminated the sex difference. In the preoptic area, we confirmed that males have more calbendin cells than females, and found that neonatal zebularin treatment led to long-term increases in the number of calbendin cells in both sexes. We also looked at sex differences in estrogen receptor alpha-expressing neurons. Females normally have many more of these cells than males in the ventromedial nucleus of the hypothalamus, as well as the medial preoptic area, which we confirmed in this study. In mice receiving zebularin at birth, there was an 8-fold increase in the number of estrogen receptor alpha cells in males, which eliminated the sex difference. A similar pattern was seen for estrogen receptor alpha cells in the medial preoptic area. This indicates that differential DNA methylation underlies the normal sex differences in estrogen receptor alpha cell number. We were able to rule out the possibility that zebularin caused the changes we observed by altering cell death at birth or total cell number at weaning, as seen in this figure. Instead, neonatal inhibition of DNA methylation increased the proportion of cells expressing specific markers. In other words, cells that would not normally express calbendin or estrogen receptor alpha now do so. In summary, transient inhibition of DNA methylation causes long-term changes in cell phenotype in the brain. These changes were sex-specific depending on the neuronal phenotype analyzed. In other systems, even small DNA methylation changes during development can alter cell fate. Our findings suggest that such processes also contribute to sexual differentiation of the brain. Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed learning about our work.